Dit is hem dan. Oorverdovend, maar gelukkig kan die ook uit. Het geluid van de Amerikaanse Hurricane Hunter op Hato. Een Hercules C-130 toestel van Lockheed dat dwars door orkanen vliegt om gegevens te verzamelen. Voor weermannen en weervrouwen die ons dan weer waarschuwen voor naderend onheil. Meteoroloog Albert Martens stapt net uit het toestel. Hij heeft rode blosjes op zijn wangen en is tamelijk opgewonden. Meneer Martens, hoe opgewonden bent u?
Hoe?
Opgewonden bent u.
Ah, woef! Ja, heel mooi.
Ja?
Dat is heel mooi geweest, ja. Ja, want ik heb de kans gekregen om vanuit Aruba met dit vliegtuig hier naartoe te vliegen.
Uh-huh.
Dat was geweldig.
Met de snelheid van een hurricane?
Nee, dat niet.
Wat is het belang van dit bezoek van dit toestel hier op Curaçao?
Elk jaar gaan ze enkele eilanden langs om de mensen eigenlijk meer te waarschuwen, maar ook te informeren over orkaansituaties. Uh-huh. En dat is belangrijk.
In de hangar van de Amerikaanse luchtmachtbasis Vol luisteren we samen naar het plechtige protocol ten overstaan van de notabelen van het dorp. Waarin ook vervoersminister Zito Jesus Leitu zich niet onbetuigd laat.
I must say that as of today, there is one more crew member and that's me. I just came in the cockpit and I heard everything that was being said. And especially what I heard is, what a beautiful place when we reach the coastline. And I thank you for that. I'm very proud.
De gezagvoerder van de C-130 is ook een vrouw. Luitenant-kolonel Dina Williams, een oude rot in het vak, waardoor mijn eerste vraag nogal zullig overkomt.
Have you ever flown inside on a hurricane?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah? How is that?
Yeah, we always say it's like a bumpy car wash, and it's very true. It's like driving on rough roads and heavy rain. So it's a different experience with every storm, but I've been doing this for over 17 years now.
Yeah.
Starting. And your first storm? How was your first storm?
First storm was Hurricane Charlie in 2004. It was an experience. Yeah.
That was forecast.
Yeah.
Were you not afraid?
I don't know if fear factors into it. It's more excitement and you've got adrenaline pumping and you kind of think about it afterwards, but it's all about getting the mission done.
So and have you ever flown inside the eye of the...
That's what we're doing every time when we go through the storm. Yeah. We actually penetrate the eye wall into the eye and then we penetrate the eye wall again going outbound.
So and then suddenly it's quiet.
It is. Like Maria and Irma that was just a couple of years ago, you break out into it and it is. All of a sudden the winds start dropping off. You look up and there's a stadium of clouds around you. So when we were flying, I believe it was Irma, we could actually see the full moon over the eye wall. And then, you know, during the day, sometimes you can actually see the sea surface as well. So, yeah.
Now, when I fly a plane through the clouds, I feel a lot of bumps coming up.
Yeah. And that's exactly,
And that's exactly the same what you feel?
Yeah, it's very similar.
And why is C-130 a plane that you can use for this type of
well,
work?
Well, this is a very hardy aircraft, number one. Number two, it's built to fly slower airspeeds. And just like going over a speed bump, you slow down when you go over a speed bump. When there's turbulence, you slow an aircraft down. Mm-hmm. That's the same for a commercial airliner too.
Yes.
So, you know, if you get hit turbulence, you're gonna slow it down a little bit. So this aircraft can actually fly slower. Also,
and still having airlift.
And still, right. And we've got the turboprops, which is better because if you have heavy rain, sometimes jet engines can flame out.
When you were at high school, you already thought you were going to do this later
on? Oh, when I was 3 years old, I knew it. Well, not about the hurricanes. I don't know. But I wanted to be a pilot from the time I was very young. Yeah. I always wanted to fly. My dad was a pilot. I didn't know I was going to be a hurricane hunter. I wasn't interested or hadn't even really researched it until I got to college and then I learned about the hurricane. I was like, that's kind of interesting.
That's interesting,
And then they were my first unit that I interviewed with and they offered me a job and I said, okay.
En nu is Dina hier. Het Atlantische orkaanseizoen begint straks op 1 juni en zal naar verwachting 3 grote orkanen naar de regio brengen. Hoe krachtig die zijn, dat wordt door Dina en haar bemanning gemeten. Recht in het oog.